Hey, Bobcat Nation. Do you want to know what life is like as a QU journalism major at Quinnipiac University? Well, I'll show you in this Quinnipiac Day in the Life. Hey everyone, my name is Nicole McIsaac. I am a sophomore journalism major with a minor in public relations from Rockland County, New York. I chose journalism because of my love for storytelling. I've always had it since a very early on age. I was involved in musical theater. I always publicly spoke at events. I just always loved the aspect of telling stories and talking to other people, communicating things to other people. I chose specifically Quinnipiac journalism because of the curriculum and programs that they have to offer to their students, as well as the many different aspects of student media organizations on campus. Today is one of my busier days of the week, but it's all filled with journalism, and that's what I love to do.
So I'm about to walk into my 8 a.m. class. I'm going to JRN 275 with Dr. Yannity. It's an investigative reporting class. It's so much fun. Every JRN major has to take it, and it basically is the foundational base to all journalism reporting. So I'm super excited.
We want to know the process, right? What the hell's going on? And who else do I need?
So I just finished my JRN 275 class. Today we began with going over some story pitches that we did for an assignment this weekend. And then we went over some sites that you could use to research information when you're going about your investigative reporting. I could totally see myself using these, not only on future assignments, but just as I go into the professional field as well. So that's super exciting. Next, I have a 9:30 class. That's all about writing for strategic communications.
Quinnipiac, it would send press releases to CNN. If they had news and so forth. So that's a publicity release.
Today we learned about effective lead writing and formatting a press release. But now that we're done with class, we're going to head down the hall to the podcast studio. We're going to work with my co-host on our podcast a little. Here behind me, I have my co-host of the podcast and my best friend, Skylar Haynes. And what really got us intrigued to start this podcast, we saw so much work going on and amazing things being done by Quinnipiac University's community and its students. And we really wanted to take the time out of our day to acknowledge all of the students and acknowledge all their accomplishments that they're doing on campus. We've heard amazing feedback, not only from the students and the community, but professors, deans, alum. It's been something that's been really positive for our overall community.
Absolutely. And it's such an indescribable feeling to be able to pull up your phone and open Spotify or Apple and look at all these artists and these podcasts that you listen to every day, and you're right there along with them. It is so professional. We get so much professional support and development within the school. We have so many amazing mentors helping us. But also, the podcast industry is huge. It's growing every single day. I talk to Nicole about this all the time. 43% of Americans listen to audio and to podcasts every single day. And so it's just amazing that we get to get our hands on this so early on, and we can show jobs that we have an entire podcast that's reaching people across the globe.
What is going on, Bobcat Nation? Nicole McIsaac here, and I'm back with another episode of The Woke Giants at QU with my co-host, Skylar Haynes. Skylar, how are we doing today?
We are doing amazing. Happy to be back in the studio today here at Quinnipiac.
No, me as well. I'm ready to spotlight another Bobcat that's doing amazing things. That is a wrap on working with the podcast for today. The work went absolutely amazing. We captivated this Bobcat story, and I'm so excited to share with everyone else. We have episodes coming out bi-weekly on every streaming platform, which is super exciting to share with our audience. Now we are going to head over to the Student Center, and I'm going to head into the media suite because today is deadline day for the Quinnipiac Chronicle, which is our student-run newspaper organization on campus. Today is deadline day for the Quinnipiac Chronicle. So basically what that means is that we edit all the articles from this past week and we lay them out on the computer to prepare for our print issue that distributes every Wednesday. I am the associate news editor, which means that I work exclusively with the news section to pitch stories, edit stories, and just overall comb through the section. But every single section head or associate works together to edit all of our content before we distribute. Joining different organizations,
especially student media organizations as a journalism major is so important to not only practice the work that you do for your profession, but also to meet other people and to get to know yourself as a writer and a journalist. Now we are done with our final edits for deadline day and we are sending out our issue for print tomorrow. But for now, I'm gonna sneak off to the cafe for dinner and I'm gonna have sushi, which is one of my favorite spots to eat on campus.
I just got my sushi and I got the spicy Quinnipiac roll and an order of edamame. The sushi place is super good to go on campus. You can use your direct meal points there. Now I have finished my dinner. I'm gonna head back to my dorm room to do a little bit of homework. And then I have our Quinnipiac Chronicle G board meeting tonight.
I'm getting ready to log on to the Quinnipiac Chronicle's general board meeting tonight. Unfortunately, due to COVID-19, we can't meet in person like we used to, but that's all right because we can Zoom each other, where we basically go over this week's issue, and then we further break out into sections, which we have opinion, news, arts and life, and sports. We break off into breakout rooms and discuss next week's stories. As the associate news editor, I get placed into the news breakout room. So beforehand, I'm assigned to create a list of story ideas for our writers to write about for next week. And we basically all have a discussion of who wants to write what, how they'll collect the information, and just furthermore details of how to get ready to write the story.
For any student that's looking to get involved, whether that just be in different organizations or student media, I would highly encourage them to try a whole bunch of different avenues. Try broadcasting, try print, try radio, whatever it is, expand your boundaries and use the opportunities that Quinnipiac presents to us so that way you can see what you like and you can also broaden your horizons to be the best reporter that you can be in the future.
Be sure to check out other Quinnipiac Day in the Life videos to see Quinnipiac all for yourself. Go Bobcats!